Hello, everyone. For the ones that don't know me, I'm James's mom, and I just want to take this time and the opportunity to thank everyone that came and supported our family during James' passing, came to the service. The ones that sent cards and stopped by, and all of the caring and wonderful things that people did that you didn't have to do. My family and I, very much appreciate that. As far as, you know, we see it being his family, it was really an untimely death, you know, that he passed on his birthday on New Year's Day. But one thing that, you know, as his mother, I have the assurance of knowing, you know, where he is and that I'll see him again. And that's, you know, a blessing in itself. I also think about, you know, we have many memories, and not only just the memories, but we have pictures of him, many pictures of him that we, you know, will be able to cherish for a lifetime. And, you know, taking pictures of family, you know, very precious, because, you know, we don't know when one of the family members will be taken, you know, away from us, you know, little ones, as they go through the different stages of growth from babyhood and, you know, starting school and, you know, all throughout their lives. And, you know, you have those memories to look back on, and, you know, those are precious memories. That, you know, with today's technology, with cameras, you know, cell phones, you know, we have the advantage of being able to utilize, you know, those items. And that's a blessing. Many years ago, you know, that wasn't available to us. But just, you know, really want to, you know, share my heart and thank everyone that came and participated. And, you know, it was a celebration of James's life and the lives that he touched as his mother. That will, you know, was very precious to me to know that the values that his dad and I instilled in him, he was able to pass, you know, those values and things that he had learned over the years, he was able to pass those things on to other young people. And, you know, the amazing part for me, and, you know, he was a barber, and he was good at what he did. He enjoyed, he had a passion for what he did. And so he met people from all walks of life. And I've only heard, you know, good reports of how he was an encourager and how he touched people's lives. And a lot of that, you know, came from the business that he was in as a barber. And so to me, you know, that was a beautiful thing. And people talking about how, you know, he will definitely be missed. And that's, you know, a good feeling when you know that you have left a legacy and lives that you have touched, instead of having, you know, someone speak a lot of negative things about you. And so it's very important as to how we do live our lives and the things that we do, because people are watching and people do notice and remember, you know, things that we do, whether good or bad. And so it's good when you can touch someone's life in a good way. And so, as I said, as his mom, that was very special to me. And the positive things that were spoken at his service. And someone asked me, did you know all of those people there? I said, no, there was many of you that I don't know, that I never met. But, you know, it was a beautiful thing for me as his mother to know that he knew, you know, the people that came, even though I didn't know many of you. And another thing for me as his mom, a lot of you I have gotten to know since his death that I really didn't know. Maybe I saw you but didn't really know you until after his death. And so, you know, I treasure that, and I'm so very thankful and humbled by, you know, all of the people that came and the phone calls. You know, I can't leave that out, because many people that couldn't come by did call and, you know, show their love and give their condolences, and that, you know, is just very precious, and we'll never forget that. That's a good feeling, you know, to a family, the encouragement that you get, you know, when you have to go through something like this. And as his mother, you know, I'm doing good. The only way I can say that is because I put my trust in God. I don't know how you can go through something like that without God. And so, you know, that is what God is the one that has sustained me and gotten me through this. I'm also very thankful for my husband, Rod, for being here with me and supporting me. And that, you know, he's a godsend, because God saw this day before I saw it. And he knew that I would need someone to be, you know, a support to me. And Rod, you know, definitely is a support. And I thank God for that. So just want to, again, thank everyone that came and gave and called and sent cards and, you know, gave love gifts. You know, we so very much, as James Harris's family, very much appreciate that. And once again, thanks.
Sing and just to sing his praises. He's worthy to be praised.
Amen.
You better lose yourself in the music.
da 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 da. You only get one shot.